Hello, YouTube. I have a fish video for you today. After a year of prep, I finally hatched a clutch of adorable little ocellaris clownfish. So let's look at the journey. For me, the hard part was getting eggs. I have a pair of maroon clowns that have mated and produced eggs in the past, but none that I've seen in recent years. Back in October, a very wonderful person offered me a trio of ocellaris that had been constantly breeding for her, and they needed to be rehomed. I took them and I put them in my 20-gallon frag tank with a nice clay pot to put their eggs in. But after being relocated, they didn't seem too interested in producing any eggs. Then, right before Christmas, I found eggs. Now at that point, I wasn't ready for them just yet. I knew I needed food for the first week, and we were planning on going out of town. But I went ahead and I set up the hatching tank for the next clutch. I set up a 10-gallon tank with about 4 gallons of salt water, dosed it with phyto to a deep green color, and then added lots of copepods. The pods I culture are mostly Tigeropsis pods, which aren't ideal. However, my hope was that by filling the tank early, there'd be plenty of young, small pods for the clowns to eat. Then, right around New Year's, they produced a new clutch. Now, this footage isn't that clutch. This is one right afterwards. They were laying eggs in the pot, but I removed the pot to hatch the eggs, and I didn't get any footage of that. So this one was on the rock, but the eggs look the same. As the eggs get ready to hatch, you can see the little eyes showing. On about the 8th day, I moved the flower pot to the hatch tank, added a bubbler, and then made it dark. The next day, the eggs were gone, and there were tiny little specks around the tank. Between the green water and their tiny size, there wasn't anything for me to film of that. On day 4, I scooped out one of the little specks and put it under the microscope. At this point, they barely swim. They're tiny, barely 2 millimeters long. Now, I've been adding more pods to the tank, and now I started adding some of the golden pearls, about 50 micron, powdered food a few times a day. He looks to have a full belly, so I think they're eating well. On day 7, I raised the water level to about 6 gallons. The fry are swimming better and growing well, and now they're about 3 to 4 millimeters long. They've got full round bellies and are eating larger 150 to 200 micron powder. But they've not reached metamorphosis yet. Also, the tank is still too green to see how many there are. At this point, my estimate was somewhere between 10 and 100. By day 11, only 4 days later, they seem to have completed their metamorphosis and are about 6 millimeters or a quarter inch long. They're now swimming and eating baby brine shrimp. The orange color is starting to come in and they look like little fish. In addition to baby brine, I started to supplement their diet with 0.2 millimeter pellets and some ground up flake food. The tank was topped up to full volume, a cycled sponge filter was added, and regular water changes are now done every week or so. At about 3 weeks, the fry begin to get their stripes, and now they're starting to look like little clownfish. They're about half an inch long, 12 millimeters, and they filled out to be almost as tall. With the water a bit more clear, I can finally get some footage of them in the tank now. But it's still too hard to count. I think there's about 30? Here they are a few days later after another water change. And finally, here they are today, happy and healthy, eating flake and pellet. I give them a treat of Grindal worms here. I think they like them. They're about 15 millimeters, tad under 3/4 inch long, and just starting to show the black outlines on their bars. Soon they'll move to the 40-gallon tank I set up for them to grow and play. In a month or two, they're going to be large enough to move on to their new homes. Hopefully the next clutch of eggs will be ready soon. If you like this, click like and subscribe to see more. Please post any suggestions or questions in the comments. And until next time, thanks for watching.